Welcome back to WSJU Radio, the number one college radio station in New York City, with your host, Introduc Kev. And today we have special guests dropping hits like No Hook, Pressure, Trisha Moore, London Hill.
Hey guys.
How's it going?
Alright,
good. You know, recent hit coming off the recent hit, No Hook. How was that? How was that studio session like?
It's crazy because I had like a 10-hour session that day, and I didn't want to waste the last minutes of the session. So I was like, you know what, let me just write this little 1-minute song real quick, and that's how that came about.
Wait, a lot of people say like their best songs, like, you know, the most random places.
Yeah, like
1 minute, 2 minutes.
Yeah.
And where, so that 10 hours, how many songs you made in those 10 hours?
Like four.
Four? Okay. So what was like the longest session you ever did? Was it that 10 hours or?
The longest. I think 10 hours. I don't think I ever went over 10 hours. I couldn't, but I can't.
Okay. So do you like to write your music or do you freestyle it?
Sometimes I like to write and sometimes I like to freestyle.
Okay. So how do you deal with the writer's block when you write some of your songs?
Writer's block. Give me my Red Bull and give me my quesadillas and I'll be fine. Then it comes back.
Okay. So, you know, let's take it back. You know, you're from the Bronx. How do you represent the Bronx when you go to different places? Like, how do you make sure, like, yeah, I'm from the Bronx?
I bring that Bronx energy wherever I'm at. So you gonna know that's a New York chick. But if people be mistaking me for a Brooklyn chick, my energy is very strong. But I always let it be known, yeah, I'm from the Bronx.
Okay. And then as a rapper coming from the Bronx, how do you stay away from, like, the politics and, like, stay and focus on your music?
Like, I don't get into it. You know what I'm saying? I don't really get into that. I could curse.
Yeah.
I stay a bad bitch and stay in my lane. Yeah.
All right. Do you feel like you get way more love from people from Brooklyn than the Bronx?
Definitely.
Why do you feel like that?
I don't know why. I just feel like they be showing me more love than, you know what I'm saying, than the Bronx.
So. All right. And then, you know, there's so many rappers coming from New York. Yeah. And being a female artist, do you feel like, as a female artist, you're underappreciated or you feel appreciated right?
I feel appreciated right by them. They show me a lot of love, like other female artists, and I love it.
All right. Who are some, like, female artists and, like, would you want to collab with? You know, we spoke earlier, like, off the record, like, Native Dancer there was there. Mm-hmm. Who else? Who do you want to collab with?
I love Young Devin. I love Lola Brooke, Billy B. That's all I can think of on the top of my head right now. Those
male,
my girls.
And then male artists, like, who would you want to collab with in New York? It's a lot of them from Brooklyn or Bronx.
We could do from the Bronx. Damn, it's mad. I can name a whole bunch. But I definitely fuck with Sleepy, Chef, Ra, Curly Sav. I like D-Them. He's good. Free Zico Nico. He's from the Bronx. That's my dog. So it's mad at him.
And, you know, you being from an upcoming rapper from the Bronx, do you feel like the Bronx got it right now? With everything that's going on right now, do you think Bronx
is... Yeah, I feel like New York is self-period.
New York is self-period?
Yeah.
Okay. So what keeps you motivated as a rapper and not lose focus? Like, what keeps your strive going?
When I feel like I'm getting off track and I feel like it's not about music no more, that's when I'm like, oh, yeah, I got to get back in my stuff. Like, I can't, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes it'd be easy to get distracted, so... You know what I'm saying? I just always keep in my mind, like, yo, you gotta keep doing this. You can't stop. You gotta keep doing it.
Right.
Well, sometimes I have people around me that remind me too, and I appreciate that.
And those people around you, who was the first person to believe in you? Like, yo, London Hill, you gotta.
I really hear my producer, Billionaire Beats, and my girlfriend. Yeah, she was the first person that put me in the studio. You know what I'm saying? And ever since after that, I met my producer, and he just kept going with me, and now I'm with my whole team, TD3, shout out to Sean, Tish Ty, you know what I'm saying? So, we got our whole little team.
And what inspired you to become a rapper? Like, what was the inspiration?
I always been in love with music. Like, when I was a little girl, like, I always been in love with music, but I was singing. So, I was like, you know what, let me just try rap. And I sounded good, I like my voice. And I was like, let me keep trying it. And I got better and better and better.
So, music was always a passion. You didn't have another passion before?
Fashion. I always wanted to be a fashion designer.
Fashion designer? Oh, and so speaking about fashion designer, would you want to use rap into, like, going to tap into different endeavors, like fashion?
Definitely. Definitely. That was my plan, regardless.
Regardless?
Definitely, yeah.
Wait, you want to tap into the streetwear or the designer?
High-end mixed with streetwear, because I do love some of the upcoming designers. They go hard. So.
What's some of your favorite fashion brands?
I love Rick Owen. That's my favorite. Ricky is definitely Bottega. So many. I like this other one, Discount Universe, Ambush. It's mad at them. It's so much. I can name so much.
Okay. And then you said you was a singer and you was, when you was growing up, who was some of the artists you was listening to?
Like Karina Pacion, Keisha Cole, Ashanti, most like R&B.
R&B?
Artists, yeah.
So let's say like, you know, Rihanna or Beyonce.
I loved Rihanna. I love Beyonce too, but I was more listening to Rihanna because she's an island girl and I'm from the islands as well. So.
Oh, what part of the island?
Yeah, I'm Jamaican.
Right, okay. Yeah, so. What's your favorite Jamaican dish?
Oxtail rice and peas and plantains.
Okay. And then Keisha Cole or Ashanti?
Keisha Cole?
Mm-hmm. Okay. So I've seen that, like, why do you believe, like, people should be tuning in to London Hill? Why should people tune in?
I feel like the real girls needed some representation, like always. And I feel like I represent for my bad bitches. And I feel like I do it for the girls. You know what I'm saying? So, always got to be a leader. All right. Okay. That's what I am.
And then, what made you want to perfect your craft? You know, I've seen that you tap into a lot of different types of beats. Reggae. Yeah. Oh, yeah. What made you want to, like, tap into everything?
I'm very versatile.
Versatile.
I'm very dynamic. I'm very versatile. I'm unique. And I don't want to be stuck into one lane. You know what I'm saying? I could do it all, so why not?
Okay, and then I've seen that, like, I went onto your SoundCloud, saw that like, your first song was, like, 2 years ago. It was, like, Freestyle.
Yeah.
I was, like, Party.
I think it was Nas.
It was
the Nas beat. Hate Me Now, yeah.
Hate Me Now Freestyle. To now your most recent song, No Hook. How did you feel you grew as an artist?
Definitely my wordplay got better. My punchlines, my cadence, me riding the beats more, and like setting a tone on the beats, like so me controlling it. If I control my songs now.
So speaking about wordplay and stuff like that, what do you believe is the best verse you ever written?
I don't know. I don't know. I like them all.
Like them all.
Yeah, I like them all.
And then, what do you prefer? Like, what should a song have more? The flow is more important, or the lyrics, or what you say should be
both.
Why do you think that?
Because I feel like anybody can have a flow. Like, anybody can have a flow. Okay, they write a beat, it sounds right. But it's like, what are you saying, though? You know I'm saying? Somebody can have a nice flow and saying bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Why not have both of them? It's going to make it more spicy. All
right. And then you speaking all that truth, all the everything that you be saying is crazy, right?
Thank you.
And then that led to the point where you seen Cardi B show love to you, right?
Yeah.
What other artists have shown love to you that you were, like, surprised? Like, oh, like, they tuned in.
Casanova, Foxy Brown. That's all I can think of right now.
Okay. And then we spoke earlier about collabs. Like, if people want to collab from London Hill, how much you charging?
We're going to talk about that.
Okay. And what's it called? So, you don't want to talk about that at all? I've seen that on your bio that you're an independent artist.
Like, yeah, I'm still an independent artist.
Would you want to end up being signed or?
If a major label do come, we can negotiate some things, and if it's right, then I'll go with it. If not, I'll just sit here and keep doing what I'm doing.
What needs to be right? The money or, like, the creativity, freedom?
Both.
Okay.
If I'm going to sign, it have to be a life-changing moment. And I love, like, doing my own thing. So we got to come to some type of amends where, you know what I'm saying, I can have control into my creativity, too.
Okay. And then you've been rapping for 2 years. You haven't dropped a tape. Is there a reason why?
No. Because I just wanted to make sure it is the right time, and I think now is the right time. I just wanted to build more momentum around my name. I just didn't want to drop a tape where nobody knew me, and it's just, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, as I'm going now, more people are starting to get to know me. So I think it's about the right time. My team agreed that they think it's the right time for me to drop my Project Princess tape.
When can we see Princess tape then?
I can't give you all of that. Kev.
No, I need how many songs on there?
Definitely want to do 10. I want to keep it short, but it's going to be all fire. Like,
okay.
Yeah. It's going to be drill, mixed with a little Caribbean, a little R&B. I'm keeping it now.
Is it going to be all you by yourself, or is it going to be features? You don't got to
tell
me the features.
No, just me by myself. I want to do something with me by myself first, and then I'll dish out the features on my next tape.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And what has been the best experience so far as a rapper?
Just the feedback I get from people and the love, like, it's just so genuine, and to see so many strangers that actually rock with you, I appreciate it. So, like, actually I'm doing something right.
And how do you feel, like, when you're walking down the Bronx and all that, like, kids are coming up like, oh, let me, can I take a flick with you and all that? How is that feeling for you?
It feels good. Like, to just even know that people are tapping in with you, as like, it just feels like I said, genuine. Like, I love it.
What advice do you want to give to the kids that look up to you?
I want them to find something that they love and be consistent with whatever they want to do. Don't listen to anybody. Nobody tell them they can't do it. And, you know what I'm saying? Just keep going with it.
All right. What do you want to achieve by the end of the year? By December 2021, like, this needs to be done. I know you talk about the tape, but what else?
Yeah, definitely my tape. I want to make sure my brand is a household name. So that's what I'm working towards right now. And I just want it to be bigger than who I am. So that's what I'm looking for.
Okay. And then I've seen that you got verified, the blue check and all that. Yeah. How's that feeling?
It feels good. It feels good. It just looked a little weird next to my name, but it feels good.
Okay. And this is my last question. I always ask this question to everyone that closes. What legacy do you want to have with the name London Hill? When people bring up London Hill, what should they associate with it?
The Project Princess. And I want for everybody that went through what I went through and are in my situation to know that they can do it and to just watch my journey. And if they can follow those steps, follow it.
Okay. Thank you for tuning in.
Thank you.
Where people can find you at?
They can find me on Instagram, London Hill with 3 L's. I'm on YouTube, the same thing, SoundCloud, all streaming platforms, Twitter, and Snapchat, London Hill with 3 L's. All
right. Thank you for tuning in.
Thank you.